56 Now, New York City's policeless future. And thanks to the radical mayor of New York, this new government with a neutered police department is happening right now, as in today. Welcome to New York City's Cure Violence Movement. Joining me now, the founder of the American Truth Project and Daily Ledger contributor, Barry Nussbaum. Barry, my head is spinning right now. I have to be honest with you. It may not look like it, but inside my brain is spinning. The Parks Department. So de Blasio just said the Parks Department's going to go in there and try and mediate some sort of turf war between gangs in the inner cities, and they're going to hand them a basketball and say, hey, you know, why don't you play a game instead of shoot each other? Oh, that'll work.
This is sociology run wild, where the mayor of the largest city in the country can literally stand on the podium in front of a group of television reporters and say, everyone can gather if they're black, protesting Black Lives Matter, everyone else is locked down. We do catch and release because that's mean to lock people up for violent crimes. Meanwhile, why aren't people screaming at him that the murder rate in New York since he went into this sociological nightmare is up, Graham, 200%. They catch and release so quickly that nobody gets stuck in prison unless, well, maybe they've shot six people. Everyone else gets out because, well, they're misunderstood and they need counseling. This is insane. And why aren't the people protesting his insane lack of understanding of law and order?
Because they're not allowed to gather. You know, this is the edict from Andrew Cuomo. And by the way, Andrew Cuomo could do some damage here and sit on this guy, but he won't because he's just as radical. You know, in the end, the governors have say over what these city mayors are doing, and the Cuomo's pretty quiet on this one, so apparently he agrees. But the bottom line is we have to admit something, Barry, that our nation's largest city is in a state of emergency right now. There are rats running through the streets while people are trying to eat on the sidewalk, while there is rampant crime throughout the neighborhoods, as you just mentioned. And the number of retirements among NYPD is exploding right now. This is a disaster in the making.
Graham, honest to goodness, when I was a little boy, you either wanted to be a fireman or a policeman because they were the most revered jobs in America. You'd have to be insane to volunteer to go to the police academy today, where you have to be in the street and be spit on, called horrible names, have your life, your personal life, doxed on the internet as if you're some sort of infiltrator trying to kill people. And yet, the people that are being abused in the streets, the criminals themselves, when they call 911, they can't understand why a police officer won't show up. Oh my gosh, this is nuts. It's got to stop, Graham, before there's literally, and I mean this literally, anarchy run wild like a movie scene, and then what's going to happen?
They need another Rudy Giuliani to clean things up. They need to get de Blasio out of there, and I'm not saying Rudy Giuliani and stuff, but they need somebody like a Bernie Kerik. If Bernard Kerik is watching right now, and I know you watch somewhere in New York, you need to consider to run for mayor and clean that city up. Barry, thank you.